This is the Trews. I'm here with Rufus Ham. Thank you for coming to be on the Trews with me.
Thank you for having me.
I mean, there's all these different type of news stories. Things have happened. There's a gale is going to batter Britain. Molly goes for... There's a woman who looks a bit like me is going to be in the Eurovision Song Contest. Because you're an expert on the concept of celebrity, these are things that are to do with celebrities. Is there anything... Like, you take that one. That's American celebrity.
Yes.
You've got to appeal to Americans. This is English celebrity. Have I made a huge mistake with David, the attractive Kelly Brook? Wondering if she's made a mistake by going out of yet another great big intimidating man.
What this magazine is basically selling you is the notion of the inside track.
Oh.
Isn't it?
But we can get inside Kelly.
We can get inside her mind. All that is somebody has sat at a keyboard with three photographs and thought, she's going out with him. There's probably a part of her that's thinking, well, is this a new relationship? Is this going well? Oh, well, we will produce the great sort of psychological insight of her, you know, her wrestling with this sort of horrible uncertainty about a new relationship.
So, but you think that really, basically, all these stories are, is Kelly Brook, as a human, is likely to endure human thoughts and feelings.
Yeah.
I'm so embarrassed by these cheating claims, says Kim Kardashian and Kanye. All right, so this is, what's going on there?
Well, again, right? I'm so embarrassed by cheating claims. So some people have gone, he's probably cheating on you. And she's gone, oh, don't say that.
I feel embarrassed now. As a human, I feel the feeling of embarrassment.
Yeah, that's all that's gone on there. That's literally...
What is this even?
Well,
what does that mean?
It's... Obviously, it's quite fun, because I know how you feel about voting.
Oh, right, yeah, because you like people to do a vote.
I would love people to do a vote.
Uh-huh.
The European elections are coming. There's this thing called TTIP, the Transatlantic Trade Partnership thing. And what it's going to do is it's going to mean that private companies can sue governments if the legislation that governments make affect the profits of those corporations.
So what would that mean? Well, governments won't be able to make legislation that negatively impact corporations.
That's right.
So that Bayer, mean more power for businesses.
Yeah, you know, Bayer at the moment are suing the EU because the EU said, you know, if bees die, the human species will cease to exist. Well, top scientists reckon it's probably because of this specific kind of pesticide. So what we'll do is we'll pass a law that bans the use of that pesticide. The bee population will increase and human life can continue.
Oh, that's pointless! What if it's not that? Then we've pointlessly passed some legislation.
70% of contracts that have been offered within the NHS, the NHS is now required to sort of put everything out to tender. It used to be that there was an NHS that had a lump of money and then that it just dished out that money to the hospitals. It bought everything as one company, the NHS. Then during Tony Blair's reign, he brought in PFI. So private companies can put in a few quid, you know, to sort of help a hospital out. And then they can take a little share to get that money back and they can adjust doing things. Well, now huge amounts of money from the NHS are going off to paying these PFI debts.
I see.
Rather than being able to benefit from buying everything sort of as big economies of scale, everything is put out to tender. So basically, there are lots of private companies who are operating within the NHS... And once there's TTIP...
They'll have more power.
They'll be able
to affect their profits.
That's it. The Trews is probably the nearest thing...
To perfection on planet Earth.
Well, no, but to the audience that get what the Trews is are probably the people who most understand what the NHA would do. Certainly in Brussels, being the voice of what I think most British people want, which is a National Health Service free at the point of use that isn't a sort of way of channelling public money into private pockets.
That's a bit of a shame if it becomes that. I think it's a very good thing to protect the NHS. My mum's been ill lately and she was in an NHS hospital. Everyone's sort of lovely, there's a good sense of sort of like, because people know that they're doing something that's like, if you're tuned in to sort of altruism and love, then it's sort of, it's almost reflected in every interaction. Every time you're talking to a nurse or a porter or anyone, there's a sort of a sense of sort of pride and love. And it must be very demoralising to constantly have the NHS attacked in the media and to have this sort of attitude of suspicion and condemnation that's probably only coming about as a result of sort of underfunding. Probably if they were given more money and these kind of issues that you're talking about, private companies trying to carve them up and share them up and sort of diminish them.
The people who founded this party, work within the NHS, are aghast to see it being underfunded, demonised, the people that work within it demoralised, and the message going out day after day after day, not good enough. It is breaking it. And fundamentally, what we want is somewhere where when you get sick, you go. We had a system in this country where it didn't matter who you were, we would do our best to patch you up. That's not to say that the NHS is perfect, that it's never put a foot wrong, that there aren't mistakes and it can't be improved. None of those things are true. But what it can't be is divvied up for these economic vampires, the absolute top dogs, who are just taking all of the cash out of the system, putting it away from tax, away from contributing again, away from it actually enriching people's lives,
yeah,
to the benefit of them at the expense of us all.
Right, now, Krishnamurti, as we know, was took and
he's the newsreader on Channel 4, isn't
he? That's right. And as a little boy, Krishan Guru Murphy was taken from his village in India and told he was going to be a world teacher. He took that quite seriously and eventually became that. Because he became so damn clever, he ultimately had to reject the position of world teacher, realising that such a position, from a spiritual perspective, was unassailable and unacceptable. Krishnamurti teaches that the very sense of a distinct and separate existence to which we cling with such desperate tenacity is an obstacle to the fullness of living. But in our ignorance, we take the obstacle itself for the fullness which it obstructs. We live by the very wall which bars us from living. Its ugly mass fascinates us because it appears so substantial and immovable, so totally objective. It gives us the certitude of our own continuity. I suppose what Krishnamurti is interested in is self and otherness, that we are constantly augmenting our own identity. Krishnamurti demands a lot of you. He won't, like, he's no easy answers with Krishnamurti. He won't just say, be nice. It's always like, well, even if you're being nice, you're probably doing it as a trick. That won't even worth anything. Be nothing at all. Krishnamurti won't be happy until we're all just a gas or pure light beaming around.
I think that's why I prefer Jon Snow.
Jon Snow, we don't mind what you do. Anyway, sometimes wears quite a loud tie. Rufus, thank you for joining us on Some Trews, teaching us about NHS and all those kind of things. I'll hold this thing up.
The NHA party.
Oh yeah, NHA party. There you go, there's some visual information.
Dun 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 dun.
I've promoted that thing.
Thank you, really did.
Nose is a tool that is abused to fool you and to leave you scared and confused. Trews is like the nose, if the nose was true. I want some Trews, let's have some Trews.